Yo, Coogee Rap, yo, Polo, you ready to bust this funky album for the people?
Yo, word, you know, boy, you about to get busy with it right now.
Yo, word up, Marley, you know what time it is.
I mean, there's too many suckers out there thinking that we can't do it. Yo, we gonna do it or what?
Yo, who year is this? Coogee Rap and Polos.
Word up.
Back again!
89, yo, all the way. Now bust something like this.
Word.
I realized it was a role. At the end, I would win lots of pots of gold. Never took a break, never made a mistake. Took time to create, cause there's money to make. To be a billionaire, takes hard work for years. Some nights I shed a tears while I was set a breeze. Been through hard times, even worked part-time in a key food store, sweeping floors for dimes. I was short of a quarter, taking the next man's orders. Breaking my back with a shack for headquarters. All my manpower, for $4 an hour. Took my time and wrote rhymes in the shower. Shoes and stuff, cause the road gets rough. But I'm a rocket cause my box ain't stuffed enough. All the freaks wanna speak cause my checks were weak. They were turning up a cheek, so I started to see a way to get a play. And maybe one day I'll be performing up a storm for a decent pay. No matter how it seems, I always cast a dream. All the girlies scream and suckers get creamed. Dreamed about it for 5 years straight. Finally I got a break to cut my first plate. The road ain't yellow and it ain't no witches. My name is Coogee Rap, I'm on the road to the riches.
Throwback Thursday, Coogee Rap. One of the best to ever do it right there. I'm telling you, one of the best to ever do it right there. I put Coogee Rap probably my top 10, maybe top 15. Man, this dude had mad skills. Didn't want to be involved, but the money will get you. Getting richer and richer, the police took a picture. But still supply, some people I knew died. Murders and homicides, bottles of suicide. Welcome back to the show. 1989 is the year. Throwback Thursday. Still hadn't told you why we're talking about 1989. We'll get into that a little bit later. But right now, let us talk a little bit of entertainment. All right, so today's date is... the hell is today's date? Ah, July 13th. Celebrating a birthday today is Harrison Ford. You know Harrison Ford. Played the great Han Solo in the Star Wars movies. Indiana Jones. You talk about some legendary roles. You played Han Solo and Indiana Jones. Great actor. Harrison Ford turned 75 years of age. He was also in Blade Runner from back in the day, the 1982 sci-fi classic. Just done a bunch of great things, man. Harrison Ford, one of my favorite movies. I think I got the Indiana Jones movies on my list of great movies of all times. Harrison Ford turns 75 years of age. Happy birthday to him. Speaking of that type of movie or whatever, space movies, Patrick Stewart. Patrick Stewart turned 77 years of age today. Happy birthday to him. Played Captain Luke or John Luke Picard in Star Trek, The Next Generation. And, yeah, I guess he's kind of typecast. And he plays Professor Xavier in the X-Men movies. Happy birthday to Patrick Stewart, 77 years of age. Good for him. He made it. Nice little run there. Also today is Ken Jeong. You know who Ken Jeong is? Ken Jeong played the dude and the Hangover movies, the Asian dude in Hangover movies. But did you die? I tell my daughter that all the time. Whenever I pick up from track practice and they had a hard track practice, and she complaining about how many damn laps or how many hurdle reps she did or whatever, at the end of it, I'll just be quiet, and at the very end of it, I'll say, but did you die? You didn't die. No, what don't kill you only make you stronger. That's also what else I tell her, too. What don't kill you only makes you stronger. But happy birthday to Ken Jeong. I think he's a funny dude. From the things that I've seen him in, I think he's a pretty funny guy. And you're listening to The Doug Stewart Show. Also today, speaking of a funny guy, man, old school comedian Cheech Marin of the famed comedic group Cheech and Chong. Cheech Marin turned 71 years of age today. Happy birthday. Long story short, if you're a greenhorn, Cheech and Chong had this whole deal. They shtick was about being weed heads. That's it. But Cheech Marin turned 71 years of age today. Happy birthday to him. I think we got a Stewie's birthday. Let me make sure. I think we got one of the listeners' birthdays. No, we don't. That's it. If you got a birthday coming up, shoot me an email at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. We love giving birthday shouts out. Yeah. One quick little entertainment story, man. Tamron Hall is back. That's right. Tamron Hall is bouncing back with her very own talk show for daytime TV. All right. You know who Tamron Hall is? Less than 6 months after leaving NBC and MSNC, Tamron is leveling up. According to The Hollywood Reporter, the news anchor is teaming up with the Weinstein Company for her very own talk show. Won't God do it? I wish you'd do it for me, though. That's right. That's right. God will do it. Wish you'd hurry up and do it for me, though. I mean, I'm not being pushy, God. But Tamron will cover everything from current events and hard news to human interest stories on the currently untitled show. She'll also be sitting down with celebrities and newsmakers for interviews on the daily program as well. The Weinstein Company co-chairman Harvey Weinstein. Yeah. Revealed that he had been working to develop a talk show for quite some time. All he needed was the right host, and Tamron fits the bill. Here's a quote from Mr. Weinstein. Tamron is far and away that person. Harvey said in a statement, she's exceptionally talented. She's a great journalist who interviews masterfully, walks the line between entertainment and hard-hitting. We couldn't be more thrilled to begin this new venture with her. You remember they basically canned her unceremoniously a while back during all of this political stuff going on with Donald Trump. And if you don't know who Tamron Hall is, I talked about it on the show before. You talk about super, super fine? Google Tamron Hall. Yeah, that's what I call fine. So congratulations to her. Congratulations to her, man. Bounce back. I love it. I love it. I absolutely love it. Today is July 13th. Today is National Delaware Day. National Beans and Franks Day. That was a common meal in my house growing up, but my mother would put it on rice. We put everything on rice. That's a meal. That's a meal. You put anything on rice, that's a meal. Beans and franks. My mama used to put salmon on rice. She used to put salmon on grits. We just put everything on rice and on grits. But today is National Beans and Franks Day. And also, man, the bane of my existence, man. Today is National French Fries Day. I literally, and I believe this, man, for real, and you're listening to The Doug Stewart Show, I think I lightweight kind of understand somebody that has a chemical dependency. I do. Because I'm telling you, man, when I'm hungry, when I need something to eat, and I don't want to wait till I get home. It's literally like I feel like a crackhead passing the McDonald's, you know, just wanting to stop through the damn drive-through to get me a large fries. I do. I mean, I have a real problem. I've talked about this before, but I think I kind of understand what it means to be strung out on some type of illicit drug. And it's French fries for me, man. And I don't care. And I mean, you know what? McDonald's is the best, but it could be Wendy's. It could be Burger King even, which they've changed there several times. It could be Chick-fil-A with them damn waffle fries. It could be pretty much anywhere. And I feel like I got to have some damn French fries, like a freaking French fries crackhead or whatever, man. But today, if you're looking for an excuse to go out and get some French fries, man, today is National French Fry Day. Yes, sir. Yeah. Yeah. Rail Scott, when I had hair, Sky says, Punkin's friends bought Doug and Ryan an Atari 2600 with an extra joystick. What? Wait a minute, man. Let me read that one more time. From Rail, when I had hair, Scott. Punkin friend, a long story about that if you're new to the show. Punkin's friend brought Doug and Ryan an Atari 2600 with an extra joystick. You don't mean joystick in a sexual connotation type way, do you? I know better than that. I mean, me and Rail go back way back, like car seats and spinal cords. I know you're not talking about my mama and her little friend in a sexual type manner about a third joystick, right? All right, I'm just going to assume that I'm making more of that comment than actually is. You my man, 100 grand, Rail Scott. Ha, ha, ha. That was funny, Rail. That was funny. Back in 3 minutes.
For this piece of change, we're living in a nightmare. Oh.